do this a couple of times, but each time you find reasons and excuses not to make it happen. Hopefully this time we are here to stay. So please do hit the subscribe button and don't forget to hit the notification bell as well, so that any upload of the review that we put up, you'll be able to get a notification to catch it. So you're talking about The Perfect Picture 10 years later. If you remember this film, The Perfect Picture, it came out originally in 2009, and it talked about three friends, Dede, Aseye, and Akese, who are trying to find love. This particular version, which is 10 years later, was released in December, but unfortunately, I and my team couldn't get to see it. Anytime we tried to go see it, something would come up, and yeah, we missed out on the premiere. Fortunately for us, it's available to stream on Netflix worldwide, so you can go ahead and check it out after you've seen this review. So this film is just a follow-up sequel of the 2009 film The Perfect Picture, which I think is arguably one of the films that changed the landscape for Ghanaian filmmaking. If you remember that film very well, there was a lot of talk about it back then, and even up to now, it's one of the films that puts Shirley Frimpong-Manson into the conversation when it comes to films. Well, I think the idea to make this sequel is a brilliant one after 10 years. Of course, to get to see what has happened in the lives of our three ladies who are the center of this film, that is Akese, Dede, and Aseye. This sequel, the 10 years later, like the title says, is talking about the lives of these ladies after 10 years. Originally, the story was about them trying to find love, but after 10 years, they found love, and it seems there's still some kind of drama and issues in their lives, and that's what this film is basically about. So let's just talk about some of the things I like and dislike about this film.
Right,
so the first thing I like about this film is the sound scoring. If you're going to sit through this film, at every point in time there's amazing choice of music that you would appreciate. I think whoever did the sound scoring for this film did an amazing job, and also most notable is the performance by the late Nana Tufor. I mean, it was so nostalgic, especially in the opening of the film. You get to see him perform, and we hardly get to see some of these things in our films, so it killed it for me. I mean, having to see that performance at the opening of the film, it just makes you feel like, wow, we have all these talents and we do not pay attention to them when it comes to our films. Also, later on at the end of the film, getting to the climax, you get to see another performance from J.W.B.L.E. Ambule. So yes, check that out. Awesome music and awesome musical performances in this film. The next thing I like about this film is the cinematography. I understand it was shot on a Black Magic pocket camera. If those who know cameras, it's a very tiny looking camera in a tiny form factor, but if you look at the visuals from this film, I mean, it's awesome. And the visuals in this film are complemented by an excellent choice of locations and settings. And that's something you can't take away from this film. All the pictures are pleasing to the eye. There's not one single scene in this film that you see and be like, I don't like this location. I don't like how this place was set up. Everything was spot on. You get to see some amazing buildings, amazing homes, and a beautiful waterfront home. I mean, that's something to die for. You watch this movie and you're like, yo, I need to get this house. Like, and that was an excellent touch to this film after 10 years. I absolutely love that bit about it. So the next thing I like about this film is the acting. If you remember the 2009 film, I mean, the acting has stepped up a notch in this particular one. All the actors have sort of matured in their experience in this film. What I also like in particular was the fact that one of my favorite actors, who is a stage play god in the form of Andrew Adwiti, gets a role in this film, and he plays the role of Reverend Tichy Manson. I mean, if you don't know this guy, this is one reason why you need to see this film, and you are absolutely going to love him. I think he's one of the best talents we have when it comes to acting in our space, and I'm happy that he's finally getting enough screen time, and hopefully people will begin to pay a lot more attention to him. I also like the role Gloria Safu played in this particular film. It's quite understandable now why she won that award. Although it's not a big role, well, arguably, it's a very central role to the story. She didn't get that too much of screen time, but her role was very important. You could feel that she really understood the character she was playing. She was able to convey all the right emotions, and every second she was on screen, she was in character, and I absolutely loved her performance in this film. Besides that, I think all the actors have matured over the years, from the Jackie Appiahs to the Lydia Fawcett to the Naa Shokor. You can see some growth in their performances in this particular film as compared to what they did in the 2009 edition. Right. So let's go to what I did not like about this film. So my biggest dislike about this film is it takes too long. 2 hours 30 minutes. Wow, is that a Martin Scorsese film? I mean, for a film that is supposed to be a romantic comedy, I do not expect it to run for that long. I also feel it's because, and that leads us to the second thing I don't like about this film. I also feel like it's too many stories packed into one. We are focusing on these three ladies, and each of them seems to have some weird drama going on in their life. And the story tries to break down what is happening in the life of all these three ladies. So it's as if Shelley is trying to tell too many stories at a go. You do not know exactly which of the three ladies you are supposed to focus on, but I think at the end of the day, all their stories have some form of resolution that makes it worthwhile. That notwithstanding, I still feel like 2 hours, 30 minutes is quite a lengthy runtime for a romantic comedy. Also, I find it weird that all these three ladies seem to have some form of sexual related issues happening in their relationship. It's quite weird for me that all three of them seem to have some form of issue that has to do with sex. It's either they're having too much sex, they are not having enough sex, or they have weird sexual fantasies. Nonetheless, I'm happy that there are other side or subplots that was able to take some attention off the sexual issues that they were having in their relationships. I also feel like this film was sold to us as a romantic comedy, but if there's anything at all, there's nothing comedic about this film. I mean, there are a few things that you can laugh about, minor things that you can laugh about, but it's not in your face a comedy, okay? If you are looking for drama, lots and lots of drama, this is the perfect film for you. I think it should have been classified as tagged as a family drama, not a romantic comedy, okay? There's all that romance in there. Of course, all these three ladies have some form of love drama going on in their lives, but the comedy, come on, there was not that much comedy in this film for it to be classified as a romantic comedy. That's in my opinion. If you are looking or you are going to this movie to find things to laugh about, then this is not a movie for you. If you love drama, if you love romance, then of course this is the film for you. So overall, I think The Perfect Picture 10 years later is an awesome movie. It's a decent movie, well shot, well edited, well acted. Most importantly, the story is just something that takes your mind back to 2009 and brings you into present day, and it was well put together. Basically, there's nothing really, there are no major loopholes when it comes to the story. I think what they set out to give to us, they were able to deliver. We get to see what has changed in the lives of these women over the course of 10 years. We also get to see the maturity that they've acquired in terms of their relationships, their family, their businesses in the course of 10 years. So I think that is spot on. Production wise, all the elements were top notch, from sound score, cinematography, editing, location, sights and sounds. Everything was just perfect, but it's too long. It's just too long. I just feel like it's something that you might probably need some patience to really sit through. Besides that, Shelley did an awesome job with this particular film, and if you haven't seen it, just get on Netflix. It's available worldwide, and check it out, The Perfect Picture 10 years later. Final verdict, I would score this movie 8.5/10. Yes, 8.5/10. There's nothing really wrong with it except the length and some of the other things I mentioned earlier on. But besides that, yeah, it's a movie I'd love to see over and over again. So you should get on Netflix and check it out. Okay, so I'm done with my review. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I spoke some sense. We'll be coming to you with more reviews on this channel, so please do not forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell as well, so that you get updates on every other review that we upload on this channel. I'm sorry about the red background. We are trying to put together a new workstation for me right behind this camera. Hopefully you should be done with that soon, and that will be where I'll be shooting the reviews from. And it just happens that I have red curtains in my room, so yeah, stick and stay. And then I hope you enjoy this review. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and like and share this channel. Thank you. My name is Tony Asankoma, and this has been the reviews on GH Movie Free TV.